Wow, the Alberta Capitol looks wonderful from this view, and the Oilers are hoping the view from Rexall Place will be just as good as Edmonton makes a run for the playoffs. They hope that they will do it in their home arena. 11 home games so far this season have the Oilers played. Kevin and Louis, the fewest of any NHL team, but that will change soon.
Absolutely, Gene. As we get set for this matchup, let's take a look at the starting goaltenders. Brought to you by Tim Hortons Premium Blend Coffee. It's always 20 minutes fresh. 24th start of the year for Devan Dubnyk. His last regulation loss was in Nashville on March 8th. He is 3-2-1 lifetime against the Predators. At the other end, well, it's all or nothing lately for 30-year-old Pekarinen. Pulled four of his last eight starts, but he leads the league in shutouts. He's got five. They started the road trip in Dallas. He got a shutout. Then he got the hook in Calgary on Friday. Two goals, two shots. Take a seat on the bench. They lost that game 6-3. The Oilers, of course, losing 3-2 in overtime on Friday to Detroit. And we are underway. Ryan Jones back in the lineup for the Edmonton Oilers. Nugent Hopkins centers that puck right out in front. Nugent Hopkins, Eberle, and Jones. We saw this lineup for the Oilers, Louis, in Colorado, but Ryan Jones was not 100%.
No, he was feeling under the weather, and it has been for the last couple of days, but feels better. Good first shift for him to get in, get a couple bodies hit. And Ryan Nugent Hopkins with a little bit of a quick chance on the shorthand side.
Jones going after Erat. Erat comes away with the puck. As the Nashville Predators and the Edmonton Oilers want to make a change, Sean Horkoff steps over the boards with Taylor Hall and Alex Hemsky. Hall, we talked about him. He was flying in that game, scored the first goal against Detroit on Friday, and right down the middle. David Legwand throws a sharp angle shot towards Dubnyk, and he will hang on. Let's take a look at the keys to the game, Louis, brought to you by the 2013 Ford Super Duty. It's built for tough.
Well, as you mentioned a little earlier, Kevin, for Pekarinen and the Nashville Predators, stop the bleeding right now. In the last two games played, Rene's been pulled early in the game, giving up six goals on 16 shots. Too high quality. They want to limit those tonight versus Edmonton. For the Oilers, closing out the game. Obviously, that 2-0 lead they had Friday into the third period. They lost eventually to Detroit in the overtime. They want to learn how to close out games, and that means a 60-minute effort. That's what they're looking for tonight.
And I guess that is a byproduct of youth, but if you want to make the playoffs, you've got to limit the excuses, and as you mentioned, get a lead and then close it out. Taylor Hall with a puck right now at center, being watched by Shea Weber. So Weber and Hall will probably see a lot of each other in this game. Roman Josi is with Shea Weber. Puck is fired in. Sam Gagne waiting for it there. Can't get it by Brandon Yip. Gagne gets it back again. He'll give it to Magnus Bjarvi. Bjarvi will send that puck in deep. Nail Yakupov on that line with Bjarvi and Gagne. Gagne, the leading goal getter and point getter for this Edmonton Oilers team. He's on a three-game point streak. Gagne with the puck now. 26 points for Sam Gagne.
Yeah, nice little support there by Gagne as well. It allowed the defenseman to step up, take the body, separate man from puck. Gagne on the back. Chuck is able to just slip in there and pick it up.
Jeff Petrie working his way in against Ryan Ellis. He'll give it to Magnus Bjarvi behind the net. Gagne waiting for it there. Sam Gagne plays it back to the point. Petrie back there. Fires a wrist shot that goes wide. Matt Halaschuk bounces it off the boards, and he'll get it to Brandon Yip. Yip gets it to center. You know he wants to dump that puck in. And Louis, nobody felt worse than that guy with the puck right now than what happened on Friday against the Red Wings.
Yeah, no question about it for Jeff Petrie. Obviously, every defenseman in the course of their career is going to put a puck eventually in their own net. It's just, you know, part of the process, being in front of the net all the time, clearing pucks, and he did just that. But overall, a real good game for him. He played the most of any Oiler in that game. Very good defensively, just that one little mishap. And shake it off, get right back out there tonight and pretend like it didn't happen.
Moving in, Bloom with a shot, and that is stopped by Dubnyk. Played over 25 minutes in that game, did Jeff Petrie. He's averaging almost 22 minutes a game for Ralph Krueger. Long shot in by Bartley, Victor Bartley. Sixth game in the National Hockey League for him. Erat with the puck, throws it towards the net through traffic. Stopped by Dubnyk, into the corner it goes. Blum trying to keep it in, can't do it. Eberle in pursuit of Scott Hannon. Hannon fires it around the boards, waiting for it. There is Erat out there with Fisher and Kostitsa. Kostitsa, a healthy scratch in Calgary, back in the lineup tonight. Number 74, and then the net comes off the moorings. As we go downstairs, talk to Gene.
Louis and Kevin, time to play Safeway's $1 million score and win. If any Oilers player scores 5 goals in tonight's game, Jessica Noy of Edmonton could win $1 million. Chop and swipe at Safeway, and you could be our next lucky winner right here on Sportsnet.
And obviously for the National Predators, losing the last two, trying to get things going here early. It's Fisher that drives himself to the front of the net. A little help from Jones there into Dubnyk. As he kind of goes through, knocks the net off the moorings, like you were saying, Kevin. And for Fisher, 2 goals in his last 2 games played, wants to keep that streak alive. And one of the guys that has to step up with the absence of guys like Hornqvist, Wilson, out of the lineup, offensive guys that are hurt right now for Nashville.
And when we were talking to him this morning, Mike Fisher told us that it was the odd man rushes that were really killing the Nashville Predators. As we take a look at the starting lineup, brought to you by Boston Pizza, your hockey headquarters destination. You mentioned the guys that are not in the lineup. And one of them was Colin Wilson, who leads the team in assists and points.
Yeah, big loss there. He had 4 points the last time these two teams met up. And for Barry Trotz, the only coach in National Predators history, I call him Trotzy's troopers. You know, it's interchangeable parts a lot of the times in the 4 lines. You can just chuck that next guy in there. Very good job at managing that and putting the players in the right positions to succeed. And he can roll 4 lines.
And they're not afraid to use the waiver wire to get bodies in.
No question.
Zach Boychuk, Bobby Butler, Brandon Yip. Rich Klune, all guys came in on waivers. Weber behind the net, gave it away. Horkak gives it to Hall, the shot that went off leg one and all the way back down into Oiler territory, where it's picked up by Ladislav Schmid. These teams met on March 8th in Nashville. They'll go back to Music City to wrap up the series on March 25th, and we'll be there. Sam Gagne works his way in. He's got Yakupov in the middle. Pass comes all the way back through the legs of Bjarne. To Petrie. Predators with 3 shots, and there's the first shot for the Oilers. And we played almost 5 minutes of this first period. Pat Halischuk plays it to the middle, and it broke the stick of Nick Spaulding. Did Magnus Bjarne. Brandon Yip. Hardly in deep. Halischuk with it now. Halischuk behind the net, wipes his way out in front and tries the wraparound, was stopped by Dubnyk.
Good play there by Halischuk, and a guy that, you know, is trying to stay in the lineup, has been in and out down the minors a little bit this year for them, and a guy that had a good season last year in his first full year in the National Hockey League, playing 73 games, had 15 goals, and right there just drives it to the front of the net, right into the blue paint. Good save by Dubnyk to stand his ground in that post.
He was down in the American Hockey League in a conditioning stint the last time these teams met. Mike Brown getting a rise out of the crowd, as he normally does, throwing his weight around. Remember, he fought Rich Klune, number 16 for Nashville, when these teams hooked up. He has the puck right now. A wrist shot off the stick of Jonathan Blum. Blum takes him into the corner. The puck's still alive. Brown tries to break free. It comes to Klune, and Klune plays it to an open wing, and Nick Schultz is there at the end of the shift. He'll just dump that puck right back in. 4 shots for the Predators. They don't take a lot of shots. In fact, they are last in the league when it comes to the average number of shots per game. It's under 25.
A little surprised Edmonton hasn't had a couple shots on net yet in this game, considering that Rene's been pulled the last 2 games played. So that's something they obviously want to change here and get some shots to this goaltender, see how he's doing in this game. But Mike Brown's had a lot of energy to this lineup ever since being picked up from the Toronto Maple Leafs. And here, a good physical play down low on Smith, finishes his check. And a little earlier before that, here's that drive by Halischuk as he just wraps it around. Good little evasive move behind the net. Goes right out to the blue paint. Those greasy goals you score in tight. They don't ask you how.
How many? 5-9-2 are the Nashville Predators on the road. And that's a bit of a turnaround from last year. They were the second best road team in the NHL. A year ago, they won 22 away from the Bridgestone Arena. A different story this year. Hannon behind the net. He gets checked, and there is Nugent Hopkins to get the puck to Eberle. Eberle plays it back up top. Justin Schultz goes cross ice. In the corner, Whitney down low. Nugent Hopkins trying to get it away from Kevin Kline. It comes to the near side. Justin Schultz pinching it. He'll play it behind the net. Nugent Hopkins picks it up. Jones at the point. His shot didn't make it through. In fact, that hit Justin Schultz. As Gostitsyn works his way across, his pass for Erat didn't work. And Nugent Hopkins starts away. Whitney catches up to it. He's got Eberle with him. Plays it to Eberle in the corner. Kline takes him there. The owner's making a change. And it comes out to Gabriel Bork. Gabriel Bork, 9 goals on the season. He leads the Nashville Predators in goals. And there's a quick shot and a reason why he almost got 10. But what a save by Devan Dubnyk.
Great save.
Smith behind the net. Again, a wraparound attempt. The puck is sitting there, and it's covered up by Dubnyk. And Schmid doesn't like the fact that Smith was poking away at it. Justin Schultz hit by that shot. And then at the other end, watch this save by Devan Dubnyk. They keep it 0-0.
Brian Whitney, an Edmonton Oiler of Irish descent. You can see that when he was a young lad, a big Boston Celtic fan as a kid in sports, runs in the family. Robert Dorgan, Ryan's great-grandfather, was part of the Irish football county champions back in 1920. Now, Ryan is from Scituate, Massachusetts, a suburb of Boston, the number one town per capita for percentage of population that is Irish-American. Apparently, it is called the Irish Riviera.
Yossi with the puck down. He'll fire it into the corner. 12:47 to go here in the first period. The Oilers officially still looking for their first shot on net. And Louis, you pointed it out, this is a guy that's been shaky in the net for the Nashville Predators, trying to get some pucks on him.
Yeah, absolutely, and something that Nashville's done a pretty good job of just boxing things out, but for Edmonton, have to have a little bit better understanding of what they're going up against. One of the better goaltenders in the National Hockey League, Pecorini, had 43 wins last year. We're a little bit struggling as of late in the last couple of games, been pulled very quickly, so test them out early here. Get some pucks from different angles, get some bodies driving to that blue paint. He's a big goaltender, a lot like Dubnyk. So you have to have that busy presence in front of the net.
The Oilers outshot the Red Wings 32-28 in that game on Friday and lost for just the second time in overtime. They're 5-1-2 when they outshoot their opponent. Brandon Yip on the far side, checked by Yakupov. Yip throws it towards the net. That goes wide. Magnus Bjarvi picks it up on the near side. Bjarvi. Mark Bystrick back in the lineup for the Edmonton Oilers. Missed 8 with an elbow problem. Cut his elbow in that game against Dallas, playing his old team for the first time. But he's out there now with Ryan Whitney. 11:25 to go in the period. It's flipped into the opposite corner. Flipped into Fisker's corner. It gets there first ahead of Klune. But Klune plays it out in front for Legwon. And there's a shot by Blum, but he missed it. He got it back again. Another shot. And it's stopped by Devan Dubnyk as this fourth line puts some pressure on. Bobby Butler. Back to the point it goes. Butler can't get through, but Ellis tries. His shot is blocked. Klune and Whitney come together. Legwon in there to help out as well. And Fistrick relieves the pressure. Sends that puck down the ice, but a little bit too much on it. And it's going to be icing.
And a real good chance out in the high slot by Jonathan Blum, who has missed the last 5 games played with injury. So for him to get back in there, and good forecheck once again by the Nashville Predators again. It's Klune that gets in there, disturbs it right there. That shot through doesn't go through, but the second one gets deflected wide. You know, some real good work down low. And you talk about the fourth line, Klune scored a goal the last time these two teams met. It was one of those types of goals. Go to that blue paint, bang it home in that 6-0 win back on March 8th. And following that up in this game here against Edmonton, just getting pucks into the offensive zone and generating those chances to the net.
Not often a tough guy gets a penalty shot too, but game in Dallas, he scored on a penalty shot. And a 4-0 win to start this road trip, the 5-game road trip that will wind up in Columbus on Tuesday. They're 1-2 so far. And 0 for Western Canada. Got hammered by both Vancouver and then Calgary on Friday. Gave up 13 goals in those 2 losses. Ryan Whitney. Given a bump there by Sergei Kostitsyn. Fights him off and gets the puck to Everly. Nugent Hopkins starts the rush. Ryan Nugent Hopkins dumps it in. He'll chase it himself against Roman Josi. Josi misses the check, and here's Everly. Everly gets surrounded, gets it back to Schmid. Schmid plays it to the boards, and waiting for it there, Nugent Hopkins. Everly circles around the net, gets away from Shane Weber, and Weber gives him a thump. Separates him from the puck, but here's Everly on the steal. Jordan Everly moving in. Jordan Everly ran out of room. And Pecorine makes the save. Jordan Everly trying to get his first goal in his last 11 games.
Welcome back. Joined by Derek Laxdal, the victorious head coach of the Edmonton Oil Kings, who finished second overall, ranked fourth in the CHL rankings, and you're getting set for the playoffs, which begin this coming weekend. And first off, tell us about your season, 51 wins, a new record for the franchise.
Oh, Gene, we had a real consistent season right from the get-go, ended up with 51 wins. We went in the Eastern Conference, you know what, and a lot of great development from our players. Curtis Lazar turned into a great 7-year-old, ranked in the top 10 of the NHL draft coming up. But you know what, from start to finish, it was a real solid regular season.
What do you think of your first opponent, the Kootenay Ice, which the series begins Friday and then continues Sunday?
They're a very good young hockey club. They really had a great second half, probably one of the best teams down the stretch. So it's going to be a great test for us. And we open up Friday at 7 p.m. and play the second game Sunday at 4. But it's going to be a great series, and we beat them 4 straight last year. I'm not sure if that's going to happen this year.
Is it easy to make sure everyone's not looking ahead to the MasterCard Memorial Cup, thinking we were there last year, we think we should be there this year?
It really is. You know what? Kootenay played us tough all year this year, and I know our guys are ready to play Kootenay on Friday night.
Derek, thank you, and best of luck on the road to the MasterCard Memorial Cup, all the way in Saskatoon, not that long a road.
All right, thanks, Gene.
All right, guys, back to you.
All right, guys, good luck to the Edmonton Oil Kings. And right now, the Oilers with pressure all over. The Nashville Predators in their end. And Taylor Hall taking that opportunity to throw a hit. And he caught Gabriel Bork. Justin Schultz, who blocked that shot, right back at it. Long shot, handled by Rene.
This is the legendary Stubby Pencil, one of many used to win a total of $7 million last year. Amazing.
Get your game on with Pools.
Well, as you mentioned, Kevin, Taylor Hall, Sean Horkoff, and Hemsky with the best shift of the game by far by Evanston. Hall finishes it off with a physical play on Bork. And a good 45 to 50 seconds spent in the offensive zone. Good cycle down low, good perimeter play, and a couple real good opportunities. The first two shots from that area on Pecorino.
6-2, the shots right now with just over 8.5 minutes to go in the first period. Ladislav Schmid will lead the rush. He'll chip it in. Bartley gets it by Gagne to Yep, who gets it out to center. Jeff Petrie back into his own zone. Earning his nail, Yakupov. Yakupov gets that puck right back again from Magnus Bjarvi, gives it to Schmid, and Schmid dumps it in, but there was a white wall at that blue line for the Nashville Predators.
And they want you to try and pass through that wall. Very important for him. They don't do that. You saw the puck gets in deep. You have to regroup, get the cycle going, get pucks in there, establish that forecheck. It's the way you have to play against the Predators. They want to clog up that neutral zone, make it tough to pass it through, and for some reason, you think you can, but you can't.
Leonard Petrell moving in with Brown going to the front of the net, looking for the rebound. Sticks flying from Scott Hannon. But it's picked up by Kloon. Kloon giving a bump there by Petrell right in front of the Oilers bench. Smith carries on. He gets stopped by Fistra. And that will chase Ryan Ellis back into his own zone. Ryan Ellis, a former teammate of Taylor Hall. Both guys wearing number 4, the Windsor Spitfires.
Yeah. Two-time World Cup champions, both of them. And always neat to go up against guys you played with in junior and obviously have that history with and want to be the better guy on each and every night you play against them. And those two guys were obviously a lot of the offensive power that the Windsor Spitfires had in their back-to-back championships.
Ryan Ellis had 314 points in his OHL career. Martin Erat, who played for the Red Deer Rebels, takes the shot. Steered aside by Devin Dubnyk. Weber keeps it in. Gets it to Erat. Josi fires a blast that is blocked by Nugent Hopkins. Quick outlet to Eberle. Eberle's with Jones. Drop pass. Nugent Hopkins walks in. Couldn't quite get the puck over to Jones. Erat. Eberle's got it now. Eberle back to the point. Petrie steps into a slap shot, and that gets deflected by Mike Fisher way up into the netting, Gino.
Well, Kevin and Louie, time to play Fan Right, Fan Wrong Trivia, presented by TELUS. Enter for your chance to win an Optic TV and Samsung prize package valued at $13,000 or tickets to an upcoming Oilers home game. All you have to do is text Oilers to 333-777 or visit TELUS.com/hockey and answer this question. What is the capacity of the Oilers home rink, which of course is Rexall Place? 15,500, 16,000, 839, 18,000 or 19,315? For every completed entry, TELUS will donate $1 to Heroes Hockey, helping at-risk youth play Canada's game.
David Legwon moving in, but there is an offside call right at the Oilers blue line.
And three good shifts in a row by Evanston. It was the Hall line out there first with Horkoff and Hemsky. The fourth line follows up with a good shift, and then this line goes out. Good cycle down low once again. And just a cannon by Petrie from the blue line, and good job by Mike Fisher. So willing to pay the price, gets himself in that shooting lane and gets a big piece of that puck to deflect it up over top of the glass.
Mike Fisher came into this game third among forwards in the NHL in blocked shots. Stefan Dubnyk stops that shot. And Bork looking for the rebound, and he'll hang on to it.
Always going to be a heavy presence from Nashville. If you look at Mike Fisher and in Barry Trotz's style, you always have that collapse defense in your own zone, protect the house mentality. And for Mike Fisher, one of the best two-way centermen out there, always willing to dive in front of a 100-mile-an-hour slap shot. Call him crazy, but it's effective.
Isn't that the name of this country song his wife wrote? Gary Underwood, of course. Anoshevsky with a shot, and that's a blocker save by Pekarinen. Taylor Hall, Anoshevsky, and Horkov with Smith doing a little pushing and shoving, and Craig Smith is complaining, but he's going to the box. He knocked down Horkov. He's complaining that Horkov had his stick. So when we come back, the Edmonton Oilers will get the first power play of this game. Craig Smith in the penalty box for roughing, and it's the Oilers' first power play of the season against the Nashville Predators. They didn't get a chance.
You're right, there was that two-game stretch against Nashville and Detroit where they didn't draw a penalty in two games, so good to see them get one early on here against Nashville.
Pitcher hits the side of the net. Ian Kostitsyn killing this penalty. Special teams for Nashville have been a problem this year for Barry Trotz. They are 25th on the power play and penalty kill on the road. The Oilers, the seventh best power play in the league, goes to work right now. And that was gloved ahead, and that's why we've got the whistle. With 53 seconds left to go in the penalty to Craig Smith.
You can't let the Nashville Predators lull you kind of into that perimeter play for Edmonton. The power play's been successful when they attack that blue paint, get pucks into that zone, have a very active stick getting pucks to the net, looking for that chaos in front. When you look at the Nashville Predators, 2-2-1 their last five, they've scored six power play goals and only allowed one against. So pretty impressive numbers considering the record. So starting to turn that department around as well.
Hemsky fires that puck in. Pekarinen stops it. Josi sends it around the boards. And then it's sent out further by Martin Irak. He and Gabriel Bork will head off. Nick Spaulding and Brandon Yip hop over the boards. Alex Hemsky's got a head of steam as he crosses the blue line. Hemsky still has it. Goes in behind the net for Hall on the carom. He'll send it around the boards. Nugent Hopkins waiting for it there. 25 seconds to go on the power play. Alex Hemsky to the middle. Justin Schultz back to Nugent Hopkins. Nugent Hopkins takes a look. Gives it to Hall. Hall back to Nugent Hopkins. Back up top, and it was tipped away on a good stick by Nick Spaulding.
Go gadget stick. Real good play there by Spaulding. Didn't look like he really had that much of a reach, but the last second just extends it. Perfect timing to deflect that pass down the ice.
And for maybe one last rush as Petrell hurries, but it went off the skate of Legwand, and that allows Smith to come out of the box. The Oilers do not get a shot on that power play. Matt Halaschuk to Legwand. Legwand shot, and that one's blocked by Fistra. Scott Hanna throws it behind the net, but Mike Brown is there to intercept it. And he'll get that puck out slowly, and Petrell will pick it up. He's got Smith with him. Petrell stops up, fires it towards the net. Big rebound in front, then Legwand sends it down the ice. Fistrick's going to go back and touch it. And that's going to be icing against Nashville.
Real nice drive there, wide by Petrell. And the fourth line's played very well in this game so far in this first period for Edmonton. And just a little pickup in the neutral zone with speed. He's a big body. Great little slam on the brakes here for a delay. Knows he has traffic going to net. Ryan Smith does a good job, drives to the blue paint. And this is a heavy rebound here by Pekarinen as he just kind of blockers it out. A la Gretz here. Put it back about 110 miles an hour.
Jones, Everly, and Nugent Hopkins up there now against the Hannon and Klein defensive pair. See if they can take advantage of that. Everly with the puck now. Nugent Hopkins gets a shot right on. Stick save by Pekarinen. Everly with it again. Everly against Klein. Spins to get away from him. He's got Jones in the high slot. He's got Nugent Hopkins in the corner. Halaschuk back defensively. And Halaschuk tries to get away. Petrie keeps it in. And then Halaschuk just loves that out to center. 2:44 to go in the first period. 8-6 now. The shot's starting to tighten up. Ladislav Schmid with a nice move to get around Legwand. Schmid still has it. Stops up against Blum. Blum knocks him down, but the Oilers able to keep it in. Schmid down low. Now he's going to retreat back and call for a change. Ryan Whitney and Jeff Petrie out there now. Erat across the blue line, dropped the puck for Kostitsyn. Kostitsyn wasn't ready for it. Erat gets the puck back again, fires a wrist shot deflected by Kostitsyn. And Dubnyk had to be sharp. Mail Yakubov on the far side to mark Magnus Piarvi. Piarvi inside the blue line, cross ice. Gagne, Sam Gagne takes a look, feeds it out in front. Oh, and Nail Yakubov had a great chance. Swing and a miss for Nail Yakubov, looking for his seventh goal of the season.
Just a great play by Piarvi to find Gagne late. Another terrific pass across to Yakupov. Just can't get a handle on it. But as you mentioned, Kevin, things started to swing in the favor of Edmonton. Five or six good shifts in a row. They're getting a puck in deep, establishing that forecheck and getting chances.
Pecorino trying to slow things down, and he makes the save. Nail Yakupov coming close. Tell us Oilers hockey here on the net.
Well, can't use your seats for a game? Donate them to the Edmonton Oilers Community Foundation Seats for Kids program presented by Stantec. Visit the community page at edmontonoilers.com for more information. Well, the Nashville Predators had a full off day on Saturday as they were given some time away from the rink on the part of Barry Trotz, and the team gathered at a local watering hole and watched UFC 158 as George St. Pierre took on Nick Diaz and won. And earlier in the day, that was the night, during the day, they booked one of the rooms at their hotel and had a fantasy baseball draft. You can see to the far right there, goaltender Chris Mason is whispering some advice to one of his teammates, who's also a teammate of his as part of the fantasy baseball draft. It was Chris Mason who was kind of the original founder of it. He was the one that pitched the idea, and it's caught on ever since.
He and Greg Zahn, though, in head-to-head competition for the beard of the year.
Guest appearance on Duck Dynasty.
Absolutely.
And he actually had a laugh about that. He says, I'm never going to catch Zanin. He's got too much growth on me already, but I love the color there.
See, and look at his is groomed.
Yep.
Zanin's is just sort of there.
Check. Keeps it in check.
I like the way you said that Zanin's beard is leading block shots with six.
Whatever works for you.
Minute and a half to go in this period. The Oilers starting to come to life in these latter stages of this period. And Louis, you mentioned the cycle going, getting shots on net. But back comes Bort. Bort, 2-on-1, drops it back. Josi hits the post. Roman Josi rings it off the iron. David Legwand couldn't keep it in. And the Predators will have to regroup. But Josi comes close to just his fourth goal of the season. Smith now to Spaulding with a shot stopped by Devan Dubnyk. Loose in front and is picked up there by Horkov. Less than a minute to go in this first period. Taylor Hall just inside the blue line. He gets surrounded. Weber plays it off the boards. Good job there by Petrie to keep that puck in for Hall. Hall and Weber. Weber sends it around the boards. Ladislav Schmid pinching against Brandon Yip. Yip sends it down the ice, and he had enough English on that one. Some backspin to keep it from an icing call. Bouncing puck, and Pekka is not going to take any chances with Nugent Hopkins there. He thought about playing it. Then he gets the whistle, but Roman Josi comes oh so close.
Yeah, a little bit of a breakdown here by Edmonton. Obviously a little pinch here and a good play to kind of get this puck in through. So you have Schultz, it's back. It looks like a 3-on-1 developing, clear 3-on-1. And for Bork, I can't believe it. He could have taken that right to the net, but he wanted to kind of open up a shooting lane, give it back, looks for a pass, back for a one-time opportunity. And Josi, who can really fire the pill, rings it off the bar. So a little help from the iron there for Devan Dubnyk on a 3-on-1. It developed out of nothing, really, when it looked like it.
Race for the puck now. Erat, he's got Fisher with him in front. But a good play by Whitney prevented that pass from getting there. 20 seconds left to go in the period. A little pushback here from the Nashville Predators. Kostitsyn, Erat, and Fisher up there now. Erat plays it back to the point. That one deflected wide, but Fisher stays with it. Klein down low. Kostitsyn behind the net, centers it out in front, right at the horn. The shot was taken by Bartley, but it stays 0-0. So Rob Falls on this St. Patrick's Day. The goalies are pretty stingy, just like you at the bar when it comes to buying around.
That's because I leave my wallet in the hotel room for safety, safekeeping. Well, everything's safe right now in terms of what is on the scoreboard. We will take a look at some chances by both the Predators and the Oilers when we come back. Scoreless, this is TELUS Oilers Hockey on Sportsnet.
Take a bow, young lady. First period scoring summary brought to you by Worley Parsons Court. Now hiring trades in oil country. Visit worleyparsons.com/careers and apply today. And as the Edmonton Oilers make their way onto the ice for period number two, I think they hope that it'll be better than period number one.
Hope.
One guy. Well, hold on. That's your second
hope.
Point. Let's get to the first point. Hold on a sec here. Ladislav Schmid. Seems like every period you get the same thing out of him.
Yeah, and the Oilers are going to have to try to get the same thing out of him for a long time. He's a UFA this summer. This is a heart and soul guy. Look at that. 27 years old. He's the guy that every good team has. He plays hurt. He blocks shots. He's third in the National Hockey League in block shots this year. They got to get a contract going with him. I've talked to a few people around the scene. Not a lot of talk so far. He's going to be expensive. They got to get him.
Okay, we got to hurry up. Go ahead.
The Oilers not dumping the puck in. When the Oilers don't play well, it's because of things like this. I don't want to dump the puck in. I'm going to try to beat two guys. Whoops, it's going the other way. I don't think I want to dump the puck in, Daryl. When we watched them last game, look, I'm going to go through two guys. It's not going to work. When they had success against Detroit for 40 minutes last game out, they were dumping pucks. Here comes Taylor Hall again. I don't want to pick on Taylor, but you're just not going to walk through the Nashville Predators. They play the most boring game in the league. If you don't dump it past Nashville, they will beat you. End of story. The first period is a good example of that, Gino.
Gee, Spector, you were all over him.
I'm just kidding. Over to you guys.
All right, thanks very much, guys. Ryan Jones back in the lineup, played 5:07. Mark Fistrick back in the lineup, played just over 6 minutes. Ryan Jones will start the second period along with the top line of Nugent Hopkins and Eberle. And Louis, that's just the way it is now in the National Hockey League. It's pairs and then somebody added to that top line. It's Nugent Hopkins and Eberle, and then that has changed as Kostitsyn brings an in-centering pass, and he was trying to find somebody to pick that up, and it turned out to be Victor Bartley. In deep, he's a defenseman. Now he'll retreat to the blue line along with Kevin Klein. Klein picks it up at center. He'll give it to Bartley. Victor Bartley made his NHL debut in that game against the Oilers on March 8th. Moving in now is Bork. Bork centering pass for Smith. Smith couldn't get the shot away. Petrie prevented that. Craig Smith lays it out in front. There's Petrie again to deflect it away, this time away from Mike Fisher. But that's Smith. Is behind the net again along with Bork. Here's Josi down low, gets it to Bork. Alishemsky defensively gets the puck. He'll turn and quickly get it to Petrie. Petrie right up the middle for Hall. Hall moving in, trying to go one-on-one against Weber. That's a great matchup. We'll look for that one all night long.
They bumped into each other a couple times already. Pekka has not faced a whole lot of shots, only six through the first 20 minutes of play, none in the second so far. A couple high-quality chances for Edmonton in that first, but he was up to the task. And he's a goaltender that hasn't played well as of late. As you mentioned earlier, Kevin, pulled the last two games that he's played. He allowed six goals on 16 shots in those two starts. But he's dialed in here. And for Edmonton, your team that comes out, as you heard Mark Spector talk about, you have to get more pucks to this guy. You have to test him early on, see if he's having one of those nights yet again. Because he's a goalie that in the three previous games shut out two teams, including Edmonton. So you don't want him to have one of those.
Yeah, he leads the league in shutouts. He's got five. His last was against the Oilers on March 8th. He got plenty of run support in that game. A 6-0 victory. There's Halaschuk from the corner. Halaschuk circles the net. Rich Klune joins him. Takes a bump there from Horkoff. Halaschuk fights it off, but gave the puck away to the captain, who turned it over to Spalding. Halaschuk shot. That one goes wide. Yakupov will pick it up there. He's got some room. Neil Yakupov flips it in. Magnus Pjärvi's going to go after it. Pjärvi against Jonathan Blum. Butler in there to help out. Robbie Butler lays it up to Klune. Klune with leg one. Bloom dumps it in. Leguan will go after it. Justin Schultz blocked the shot in that first period. None of the worse for wear, though.
Unfortunately, from his own player.
Yeah.
It was a Jones shot. A good job by Schultz to pinch that time. And Jones in the high slot gets a shot, but he looks okay.
This is a replica of the remote that inspired the big win. The original was tragically lost in a couch.
Get your game on with Pools.
Well, we've talked about him as the Big Easy. We've talked about him as Dubatron. But one thing he did was get that short memory after the giving up that long distance goal from David Leguan in the game. And he got pulled in Nashville. And that's the way you have to be.
No question. You know, that was a little bit of fatigue for Devin Dubnyk starting his 10th in a row here in this game tonight versus Nashville. So you know he has a very long memory. Won't forget that, but wants to be better tonight. Faced 10 shots for the first period, 20 minutes, and a couple of real high-quality ones at that. A 3-on-1. He stopped them all.
Bartley steps into a shot, and that one rises over top of the net. Klein tries from the other side, and that one hit Fisher. Kostitsyn, Erat, and Fisher, the forward line. Weber steps out on the blue line as the Nashville Predators able to make a change in the blue line while the puck is still in the Oilers' end. Josi and Weber out there now. Bringing it back is Gagne. Bounces that one, and he sees that one go wide. Weber makes a quick up for Smith. Smith to Bork. Bork hit the post in the first period. Now he'll fire a shot that doesn't get through. Schmid blocks it. And he takes Bork into the boards, and Mike Brown will get it. Brown to Ryan Smith. Smith, Petrell, and Brown, the fourth line up front now. And he sends it around the boards. Brown there to stop it. Gets it to Petrell, gets it to Smith. Smith behind the net, now to the corner. David Leguan will pick it up, and Leguan bounces it off the boards and gets it out to center. Jeff Petrie retreats. He's got Gabriel Bork watching him. Petrie to Brown. Brown against Nick Spaulding. Swept in there by Petrell. Ryan Ellis under pressure from Ryan Smith. Ellis plays it around the far side, and waiting for it there is Matt Halaschuk to Martin Erat. Erat. Drop pass for Spaulding, but he dropped it behind him, and that allowed Mark Bistrick to come up with the puck. Bistrick gets double teamed, but does get the puck out to Jones, and he gets stopped by Blum. Halaschuk bounces it back in. Not exactly classic end-to-end hockey right now.
No, that's exactly the way Nashville likes to play. They love to clog things up, make a little bit of a battle inside of a battle. And the only way you can get around that is to make them get back into defensive zone play defense. Edmonton hasn't been able to do it enough in this game so far. Good defense by Nashville. Very quick outs in the defensive zone. And credit them. They've driven wide. They've gotten pucks to the net. They've cycled well. They've had some good chances.
And nobody's had a shot on goal in the first 5 minutes of this period. Sean Horkoff with it now. He gets double teamed. And the puck comes right out in front. It's picked up there by Schultz. He'll give it to Whitney. Ryan Whitney. And offside at the line. And Gene, he's got his mic open. That means he wants to talk.
Yeah, time to get back to work here and tell you about Safeway's featured participating product for tonight's hockey game. It's Yoplait yogurt, Minigo, or Tubes.
Well, Devin Dubnyk had to get out of the way of a high riser here by Bartley as you watch this good traffic going through the seam. And watch this puck, the last second for Dubnyk. He wants to reach up and try and get this one, but he decides, you know what, better off just to get the head out of the way of that blast from Bartley, the blue one.
Bartley without an NHL point so far.
Yeah, he's been a real nice story here for Nashville. Played his first game back, the first meeting between these two teams on March 8th. And a guy that got injured a couple of years ago. Down the American Hockey, went over to Sweden, played over there for a year, got a contract with Nashville to play down in Milwaukee, and getting his first chance in the National Hockey League, now played with Jordan Eberle in Regina for a season and a half, and has that offensive upside. We've seen him jump in a couple of times. You saw that shot there. He can crush it from back there. So a real nice story and a good find for Nashville.
Speaking of injury, Brandon Yip has gone to the dressing room for the Nashville Predators. We'll try and get you an update on his situation. They are already without Paul Gostad, Patrick Hornquist, and Colin Wilson.
And for the Nashville Predators tonight, dressing 7 Ds in this game and only 11-4, so down to 10 now with Yip in the dressing room.
Erat picks it up. Looking for Josi. Roman Josi cutting for the net. Josi still has it. The backhand stopped by Dubnyk. And the rebound cleared away. As Josi drives the net. And Stephen Yossi is the guy that hit the post in the first period. Go in there against Magnus Niarvi. Yakupov centering pass, and it was picked off by Weber. Weber, his pass for Kostitsyn didn't work, and Kostitsyn headed to the bench. 13:50 to go now in the period. Predators without a shot. The Oilers have one in this period. Brown with the puck now on the near side. Ryan Smith trying to get it against Blum, and Petrell was a stride offside. Tell us Oilers hockey, and it's right here on Sportsnet.
We'd like to invite Oiler fans to check out Episode 3 of Oil Change, premiering on Sportsnet Sunday, March 24th at 11 p.m. on Sportsnet West. The new episode follows the team on the longest road trip in franchise history. 9 games in 8 cities in 17 days. Here's a quick look at a clip from the episode.
We use the airplane times, even if we're not in a back-to-back, to really analyze what's just happened in the game while it's fresh.
That's going to be tight tomorrow. There won't be a lot of scoring chances in that one. It'll be a tight one. We'll be ready.
The assistant coaches are working feverishly. Louis DeBrus, I don't know if you picked it up. He's snoring at that point in the back of the plane.
You're the only man I've ever known that can actually sleep without even leaning back, just sitting straight up. But yeah, you know, a lot of work goes on right after a game when it's fresh in your mind. You get the video uploaded, and the coaches will bring players sometimes up to the front of the plane, try and break some things down so it's fresh in their mind to work on. And those guys are always going at it, trying to find that little advantage and things that went wrong, trying to correct things.
Brandon Yip is back at the bench for the Nashville Predators. Louis mentioned 7 defensemen dressed, so they need all the forwards they can get. He is back on the bench for the Nashville Predators. Nashville Predators will continue this road trip. They'll go into Columbus on Tuesday and then be at home to Calgary. The Oilers continue their homestand. They'll take on San Jose Wednesday, St. Louis Saturday, and then it's in the Music City for a game against Nashville. Back-to-backs with Nashville and St. Louis next week. We'll have both of those games for you. Smith trying to center it. Craig Smith. Everly. Nifty little pass there to Schmid. Now he'll get it to Jones. Jones going one-on-one against Blum. Ryan Ellis gives him a little help. The puck's free, and now Legwand and Everly both go down. Bodies everywhere. Ellis also hit the deck.
That's
then
bad.
Ellis runs in to Nugent Hopkins, knocks him down, and indeed a penalty coming up to the Nashville Predators. And it's going to be cross-checking to Ryan Ellis, and the Oilers will get their 2nd power play of this game.
And you know, for Nugent Hopkins, he loves to do that quick little spinorama, and he's so effective at it, and he has such good edges. And for Ellis right here, it's not the fact that he bumps into Hopkins from behind, it's where his stick is. That cross check right in the middle of the back kind of pushes him face first into the boards. And he's going to go to the box 2 minutes for that. So the 2nd power play to Edmonton coming up here.
They had 3 power plays against the Red Wings on Friday, 0-for-3. They have scored 13 goals on the power play at home. They are the 4th-ranked power play at home in the NHL. Gagne plays it to Everly. Everly back to Whitney. He and Yakupov are at the point. Whitney moves to the middle. Yakupov, one-time blast, pad save by Pekarinen. Yakupov gets that puck right back again. Nick Spaulding watching him. Sam Gagne goes to the far side. Everly there. Magnus Bjarvi's in front of the net as it comes to Whitney. Whitney takes a look. A wrist shot through traffic. Yossi got the block on it. Gagne gives it to Everly. Everly back to the point for Whitney. Yakupov ready to go. Whitney gives it to Everly instead. Everly down low for Gagne. Gagne takes a look. Gagne moves to the middle. Now he'll find Everly. Everly. Whitney fires the shot. Deflected wide. Behind the net for Yakupov. Yakupov pushes it. Gets it to Sam Gagne. Back to Ryan Whitney. Whitney. Another wrist shot through traffic. The bang away. And there's Magnus Bjarvi. A power play goal. The Oilers on the board. Here in 6th of the season.
And a much better power play they had in the first period. Right out of the go here, it's Yakupov for that first one-time opportunity. That sets everything up. It builds a little chaos, gives you a little respect on the perimeter. You're going to get pucks to the net. Good job by Yakupov down low to dig this puck loose. Again, it works around the perimeter. It's not a hard shot that gets there. It's a little wrister by Whitney down into the traffic. Nice little pass here by Gagne to dig it loose, give it to Bjarvi. He bangs it home on the backhand in the blue paint, planted in front. They're going to score a lot of goals from there, and it's a big one for his team.
So Magnus Bjarvi gets his sixth goal. And the Oilers have a 1-0 lead at 8-11. Jordan Eberle gets one of those assists. He's got 13 on the year. And Ryan Whitney picks up a point, giving him half a dozen helpers. Gene.
Kevin, by swiping a free club card, Elizabeth Galton of Fort McMurray has won the Universal Music CD prize pack, courtesy of Safeway, and Yoplait yogurt, Minico, or Tubes.
So the Oilers strike first and get their first goal against the Nashville Predators this season. Power play now has 25 goals. They came in tied for fourth with the most power play goals in the league.
And my bad there, Kevin. I said it was Gagne that gave it over to Pierre. It was actually Jordan Eberle beside the net, so messing up on a Gagne point again.
He doesn't need
me. I keep taking him away from him.
He's got 26 points on the season. Jordan Eberle now has 19 points. And Magnus Bjarvi continues to produce. This is his second time he's been recalled, remember. Came back on February the 5th, and he is getting the job done lately. 4 points in his last four games for number 91.
And one of the guys for Ralph Kruger said has done everything that we've asked him to do. And one of the things they want from Bjarvi is that presence in front of the net, driving to the pipes. And look where he's standing, right in front of the goaltender. He's in the right spot at the right time. He has that position. Pretty hard to take that away from him once he's playing himself there. He has good hands, and he used them there to take it from the forehand to the backhand, tuck into the wide open net. So a real good story for him this year to kind of get himself back on track. Was struggling a little bit earlier on to find his identity, but this is the way you have to play in North America. For Pierre, he has that speed, has that size, and now it's paying off because he's bought in.
His dad's in town too, so I want to...
Well, that's the boost.
Absolutely. Nick Smalling gets that puck out to Halaschuk. Picked up. Blum with speed. He'll play it to the middle. It got by Smalling. Yip trying to keep it in. And Ellis is going to be chased back into his own zone. 12-9, the shots on goal in favor of the Predators. But it's the Oilers with a 1-0 lead. They open the scoring against the Red Wings as well. And one of Louis' keys to the game is the ability to close out contests with the lead. There's still a lot of hockey to be played in this one. But the one thing you want to do, Louis, is plant some doubt in the seed of a team that has given up a lot of goals in the last couple of games. Leguan dishes off to Bork. Spinorama move. Petrie going after it. He had to deal with Butler in front. Bork's got it. He'll give it to Butler. Butler, Leguan, and Bork. Providing all kinds of problems for the Oilers right now. It is David Leguan, longest serving member of this Nashville team. Feathers that puck in. It's picked up by Gabriel Bork. Bork down low for Leguan. Checked by Schmid. A chance for Gagne to get that puck out. He just wants to relieve the pressure and send it down the ice. And back to get it is Weber. So those guys are not going to be able to get out. It's so important, Louis, like giving up a run, you know, in the next inning, you want to be able to score, and this is so important when you score a goal, not to give up anything too quickly.
Followed up, and you know, a real extended shift in the defensive zone here for this line that's on the ice for Edmonton. Good job by the line by Nashville. You know, especially Bork, who's been flying here, leads the team with 9 goals, was all over it there in the offensive zone with Leguan. Good cycle, tire that line down, keep him on the ice. Important faceoff here.
Gagne won that draw, gets it around to Yakupov. Bartley pinches in. Now it's Schmid. He'll send it around the boards. It gets by Klein, but Klein touched it. That'll allow the Oilers to get a quick change in, and they need to do that. They'll get the top line out there. Schultz and Whitney on the blue line as Fisher brings it in. Fisher cutting for the net. Mike Fisher's shot, and that one rang off the post. Mike Fisher, the second Nashville Predator, to hit the iron.
Good speed on that transition there by Fisher. Good job by him with speed to attack the line, go inside out, and rings it off the bar.
Jones' shot is handled by Pecorine. Mike Fisher, 6 goals on the season, 2 in his last 2 games, but not here.
It's time to play Fan Right, Fan Wrong Trivia, presented by TELUS. Enter for your chance to win an Optik TV and Samsung prize package valued at $13,000 or tickets to an upcoming Oilers home game. All you have to do is text Oilers to 333-777 or visit TELUS.com/hockey and answer this question. What is the capacity of the Oilers home rink? Is it A, B, C, or D? For every completed entry, TELUS will donate $1 to Heroes Hockey, helping at-risk youth play Canada's game.
David Legouin, Sean Horkoff face off. Legouin wins the draw. They send it around the boards and hopped over the stick of Mark Bystrick. 8.5 minutes to go in the second period. A 1-0 lead for Edmonton on the goal by Magnus Bjarvi. Magnus Bjarvi now half a dozen on the season. Horkoff with the puck. Drop pass for Hall. Taylor Hall snaps a shot. Then he had to be sharp. That was through a crowd.
I like that shot by Taylor Hall. Good job by Horkoff to drive right through the middle. Acts as a screen for Hall. Just gets it there.
And a penalty coming up, and it's going to be a holding call. Aleš Hemský headed to the box, and the Nashville Predators are going to get their first power play of this game.
Gets a little tied up here in the offensive zone, battling for a puck here. Watch him going against Spaulding. It's that stick in between the legs of Spaulding right there. And as he pushes him, he falls down. Good chance right before that off the rush for Horkoff. It'll drop through the legs, drives through, takes two defensemen out. And a real good job by Hall to find that little seam, get that puck through there. Not an easy save for Rinne, who comes up with it. And the Predators will go on their first power play here on that Hemský penalty.
And Louis, I think you mentioned the fact that the special teams for Nashville starting to improve on the power play. 6 power play goals in their last 5 games. They were 1-for-2 in the game against Calgary. That game on Friday. Their first chance here, David Legouin. Bork lays it back to the point. You know Shea Weber is going to be out there, and he's got the puck right now. Bork gives it back to Josi. Josi to Bork. Legouin. And his pass for Josi gets away from him. They had 4 opportunities in that game in Nashville March 8th, scored on 2 of them in that 6-0 victory over Edmonton. Gabriel Bork. David Legouin. Trying to feed it through, but a good play there by Schmid and Brown. Back to Weber, steps into a slap shot. That one goes wide. Bork behind the net. Bork. Back to Weber. Weber steps into another shot, and that one was blocked by Mark Bystrick. Bystrick sends it down the ice.
He's got to sting a little bit. I'll tell you, every time Shea Weber shoots the puck, it's amazing. He just crushes it. And even when he misses the net, it's chaos afterwards because you don't know where it's going to bounce to. It still has so much velocity on it once it comes off of whatever it hits. And you saw it there bounce off the back wall, almost right into the slot.
Well, you and I talked to Ladislav Schmid the last time about how he blocks shots and what it takes to block one from that guy.
Yeah, and he says, you know what, he tries not to see who it is that has the puck. He just wants to make sure he's in the right position. Good block here by Bystrick right up in that elbow area. He's getting back after missing the last 8 with an elbow injury, and that can't help it too much right there. I don't know if that's the one that he hurt, but a good job by him to be in that position and stand his ground.
Well, Scott Hannon has left the game, an upper body injury. He will not return. Nashville down to 6 defensemen. 35 seconds on this power play. Kostitsyn will give it to Ellis. Get it right back again. Sergei Kostitsyn. Erat trying to send it through. An opportunity now for Butler. A couple of cracks at it. And Ryan Smith is there to send that puck down the ice. The Oilers, the 8th best when it comes to killing penalties in the Nashville Hockey League. Kostitsyn drops it for Erat. Erat sends it around the board. Korkov. And Nick Schultz sends it the length of the ice. Concern on the bench for Jeff Petrie. We'll try and get you more information on that. So injury is a key factor at this time. And an icing call against the Nashville Predators.
Well, just look at his face. And, you know, when you see a guy wriggling on the bench, you know that he obviously took a shot somewhere. And looking down at the skates, and right now it's got its own pulse. Probably for Jeff Petrie, but paying the price in front once again. And he's a tough kid, you know, there's no question about it. When you're going to go down and block shots like that, you put yourself in a vulnerable position. He's so effective at it, though. A long, lanky guy at 6 foot, almost 4. And he gets that leg out and caught him in an area where there probably wasn't too much padding.
Well, they did a great job. In fact, no shots through on that power play. And you saw examples of the blocks. The Oilers 5th in the league in block shots.
Good puck possession there by Nashville in that power play as well. And as you mentioned, they've dialed that in. 6 power play goals in their last 5 games played. So it's almost like they jab at you, jab at you. Obviously, they have that knockout punch with Weber back there in the blast. But got some guys that can move the puck around very effectively, and a good job by Edmonton to stay composed, stay tight, and block a lot of those attempts that tried to get through.
5.5 minutes to go in this period as Klein and Piarvi tie up right at the blue line. The puck squirts free and is picked up by Bartley. Victor Bartley hammers it in. That one hits Schultz, Justin Schultz. Gagne trying to get it out as the Nashville Predators make a change. So everybody getting stung by the puck in this one. Over skating it was Butler, and the Oilers come right back in. Jordan Eberle, drop pass for Whitney off the skate. Bennett in front. Pekka-Rinne back in the net. And now Josi got the stick chopped out of his hand, and that's going to be a penalty. And the Nashville Predators are going to go right back on the power play.
And a tough one here, and I think for Nick Schultz, he didn't know whether or not this was going to be a breakaway. Eberle was there, but doesn't want to take the chance, comes down and gets a little aggressive on the stick of Josi, and he'll head to the box for two.
Look at Nick Schultz in the penalty box, and the second straight power play for the Nashville Predators. You mentioned it in the break, playing with fire with this Nashville power play. Fisher behind the net. Back up top it comes for Gustafsson, hops over his stick. Ryan Smith in pursuit. Smith and Gagne up front of the penalty kill. Schmid and Petrie, good to see Jeff Petrie back on the ice as Fisher brings it across the line. Fisher stops up, takes a look, plays it back to Gustafsson at the point. Gustafsson feeds that through, deflected it. Devin Dubnyk makes the save. Butler may have got a piece of it. Erat against Petrie. Erat, Butler, Fisher, and Gustafsson, along with the one defenseman, and this guy, the captain, Shea Weber. Weber throws it in behind the net. Waiting for it there is Martin Erat. Erat trying to get it back to the point. Cut off there by Gagne. And then finished off and sent down the ice smartly. And Ladislav Schmid, look at Pekka-Rinne trying to keep things going. With a minute to go in the power play to Nick Schultz. The penalty to Nick Schultz. And here comes David Legwin. Legwin to Smith. Craig Smith. He gets stopped by Brown, but it comes back to Josi at the point. He'll deliver to Smith. Smith takes a look. Traffic in front. Smith still has it. He gave it to Bork and get it right back again. Smith goes cross ice instead. Josi waiting for it. Weber loads the gun and scores. Shea Weber fires a bullet to tie the game at one.
Absolute cannon by Weber here. And just an incredible shot by him. Good work again by Nashville. Under some pressure here to maintain possession. Get this puck set up. And a real hard cross seam pass right here by Smith. It gets through. That's where they want it. So the right-hand side sets up the one-timer for Weber. And he just absolutely crushes it. Top shelf on Devin Dubnyk. A little bit of traffic, obviously, in front there. But he picks the corner from back there. And for sure over 100 miles an hour, that blast there. And ties this game 1-1.
For Shea Weber, his fifth goal of the season. But just the second on the power play. But now seven power play goals in the last six games for the Nashville Predators. And we're tied at one. Special teams in the second period coming through. And it's a 1-1 game. Josi and Smith get the helpers on the goal by Shea Weber. Spalling behind the net. Sent down by Halaschuk. Halaschuk with Yip and Spalling. Hemsky with it now on the near side. A bouncing puck comes to Spalling. A play behind the net for Yip. He got knocked down in his attempt to get there. Tripped over the post or may have gotten a little help from Devin Dubnyk. Halaschuk hammers it right back in. Dubnyk will stop it up. 2.5 minutes to go in the period. 15-12. The shots favor the Predators. And it's kind of playing into their hands. They're the lowest shooting team in the league when it comes to shots on goal. Petrie fires a shot. That gets deflected wide. Eberle against Ellis. Eberle wins that battle. Now he's got to deal with Jonathan Blum. Schmid back to the point. Jones waiting for it. A wrist shot. Blocked before it could get through by Mike Fisher. Again, the third highest block total for any forward in the National Hockey League. Tipped right on. Devin Dubnyk. Two big saves. Ellis at the point. Trying to keep it in against Eberle. Retreating back is Jonathan Blum, being watched by Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. Ellis. Blum plays along the board. Schmid had his man tied up, and that was Bourne. Petrie with a hit on Martin Erath. Opportunity for Josi now, snaps a shot. Close save, Devin Dubnyk.
Pro Hockey Life, the ultimate hockey megastore.
Another good save here by Devin Dubnyk. Roman Josi comes in. He can really fire it as well. He rang one off the bar in the first period, and here tries to go high glove. And Dubnyk was ready for that one after some good work along the boards by Nashville to get that puck free and get it over to the open man.
16 saves for Devin Dubnyk so far in this game. As Alex Hemsky starts away with Hall. Taylor Hall gives the puck to Gagne. Gagne moving in, snaps the shot. Big rebound in front. Opportunity for Hemsky. Stopped by Pekkarinen. Hall with it now. Wraparound attempt. That is denied. Back to the point it comes. Fistrick with it. Gagne over to Schultz. Nick Schultz takes a look. He'll feed it right in. Deflected by Hall. Caught by Rene. So we're seeing a couple of big goaltenders with their flexibility and agility keep it a 1-1 game.
Well, you said it best, Kevin. Both guys 6'6", and they can both move very well. Here's a good first shot by Gagne. Great chance by Hemsky coming through to try and put it 5-hole on a big man who closes it up as he slides across on the second opportunity. So he has to go right, then come back left and reacquire that puck off the stick of Hemsky. Good job by Rene there to stone a couple high-quality chances.
9-6 for Nashville, according to our stats man, Paul E. Dangerously. The E stands for everywhere.
And he is everywhere. He's never wrong.
42 seconds to go in this second period as Ryan Whitney retreats to pick up the puck as the Nashville Predators make a change. 17-15 the shots. Nugent Hopkins pass for Petrie was behind him. Checked by Kostitsyn. Petrie recovers and gets it back to Whitney. Whitney up the middle for Eberle. Eberle with speed across the blue line. Ryan Smith steps into a shot. That gets blocked by Kevin Klein. Kostitsyn trying to get that puck to Matt Halaschuk. Stopped by Petrie. Ryan Smith is there. Justin Schultz is in the room for the Oilers. I believe a cut to his face. We'll keep an eye on that one. He blocked a shot as well as the horn goes, and the period comes to an end. And special teams for both teams come through here, Rob Falls, in this second period. 1-1 the score from Rexall. Rob, it's up to you. Turn on his mic.
Thanks, Kevin. As you said, it was special teams that turned things on, and it appears the pace has been turned up a little bit as well. 1-1 the score after 40 minutes of play at Rexall Place. PRB gets the Oilers on the board. Nashville replied on the power play. We'll come back with a look at that second period.
Scoring summaries from the first and second period brought to you by Worley Parsons Court. Now hiring trades in oil country. Visit worleyparsons.com/careers and apply today. Nothing in the first, a little more in the second, and that's where we are through two periods of play. We've told you about the fact Justin Schultz had to leave the game late in the second period of play. This is what happened. David Lightwine just kind of slaps the puck, and as you see it there, it gets him right kind of in the mouth area, and there he goes. Justin Schultz leaves. You can see a little bit of blood. TD Force taking care of him at that point. He has yet to come out of the dressing room, so the Edmonton Oilers for now without Justin Schultz, and now we've got an update to the update. He's out there. Thank
you. He's a hockey player. If he doesn't play because of that.
Breaking news. Tweet it. Come on.
He's out there. I hope he's out there.
Here's some non-breaking news. Devin Dubnyk continues to play well.
Yeah, Devin Dubnyk is the question always arises. Is he going to be the guy when you have a team you think can win a Stanley Cup here in Edmonton? Will it be with Devin Dubnyk between the pipes? Well, I'll tell you what. So far, he hasn't proven to anybody that he's not the guy. Economy of motion outside of that great toe save, kick save, and a beauty, Gino.
Yes.
He is the big goalie that the less he moves, the better he looks. Doesn't move much. He's got a 918 save percentage. Gene, By the end of this game, there are going to be only two guys in the National Hockey League that have seen more shots against this year than Devan Dubnyk. He's holding the fort.
One of the most important things, I think, for a goaltender is for everybody in front of him to believe in him. Do you think that the Oilers now feel like he's the guy?
Well, if you're Devan Dubnyk, you got to shut the door this period. I know exactly what the Oilers talked about. They talked about what happened last time against Detroit. They talked about having it not happen again tonight against Nashville.
All right, we're done just in time.
Thanks, guys. Third period underway, and we'll update the update. Justin Schultz is not on the bench. So we'll try and get further
he's
information.
Back again now. Okay.
Okay, now he's come
this
back.
This is getting ridiculous.
He went out. We told Gene that he was back. Then he went back in the dressing room. He is on the bench. We can confirm that as the third period gets underway. Number 19 on the bench.
You know what I liked about it? He took that puck in the face. I mean, trust me, it doesn't feel very good when that happens. But he looked back to make sure that his defense partner was going to get the puck possession before he got off the bench to go get repairs. So good heads up play by him. Tough kid to take it, stay in the game long enough to make sure it's under control, then goes and gets some zippers.
The Oilers trying to win their first game when tied after 40 minutes. Nashville looking for their sixth win when knotted after two periods. David Legault gains the zone. Quick shot there by Bork. Looked like he lost it, and then he found it, and fired it towards Devan Dubnyk.
Good job by Hemsky to knock that one out of the air, get it out of harm's way.
Smith will give it to Roman Josi. Josi trying to get it to Legault. He was checked there by Justin Schultz. Taylor Hall gets there ahead of Brandon Yip, but Yip ends up with a puck behind the net. Yip turns to get away from Whitney, tries the wraparound, paddle down for Devan Dubnyk. And the Oilers get that puck out to center. Justin Schultz, Yip bearing down on him, plays it around the board for Whitney, quick out to Hall. Hall, nice pass to Horkov. Horkov moving in. Yakupov fires that blast, and Pekka looks for it as Horkov looks for the rebound.
Cheers for the home team from the home team. Home Hardware, homeowners helping homeowners with expert advice.
Nice save there by Pekarina, Kevin. One of the things I like about this play is that Yakupov shoots it off the fly, gets himself opened up. Nice little dish by Horkov. And he crushes the one-timer and a good leg save pass. By Rina to get it down and just kind of squeeze it against the ice.
Fistrick with it now. He'll play it off the end boards, looking for Gagne. Roman Josi can't get it by Yakupov. Yakupov, a slippery little move to get away from Josi, and then Josi takes him down. They battle for that puck. And it's finally just tipped down the ice by Nick Spaulding. Bistrick will go back and get it. As for Yakupov, hopped over his stick and then went by Legault as well. Blum sends it around the boards for Ellis. Ryan Ellis through the middle. Legault pushes it to Butler. Butler moving in. He's got Smith with him. Here's Butler with a backhand. Smith trying to get a stick on it. Just out of his reach. Craig Smith tied up there by Schmid. Butler in there as well. The puck comes free. Ellis at the point, moves to the middle. He'll backhand it into the corner. Craig Smith, given a bump by Schmid, and then Smith gets the puck back again. Fisher off the bench, turns for Ellis. Ellis down low for Smith. Good defensive play there by Yakupov, comes back and takes the puck away and starts the rush. Nail Yakupov, across the blue line. Yakupov couldn't get the shot away and had to have his head up or Fisher was gonna take it off. They'll head to the bench. 3 minutes gone in this third period. Two teams will hook up again in Nashville on March the 25th. Ryan Smith playing in his 48th career game against the Nashville Predators, has 17 goals. Fisher with it now. Fisher, Erat, and Kostitsyn. Fisher through the middle, drop pass for Erat, snaps the shot, Fisher the rebound, slid it just wide. Ryan Whitney gets stopped, Fisher's got it. Mike Fisher, nice little move at the blue line. He will go for a skate as the Nashville Predators want to make a change. Bork will backhand it in. He's out there with Smith and Legault. Craig Smith on the intercept. Smith against Whitney, now to the corner, Gabriel Bork. Comes together with Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. It comes to Smith. He's got Legault out in front. Couldn't get it to him. Legault with the puck now. David Legault turns. Justin Schultz tracking him. The puck goes wide on that shot by David Legault. Now it's chopped out. Jordan Eberle in a race against Weber, and Weber got the stick in the way. Roman Josic will give it to Gabriel Bork. Bork will dump that puck in. Devan Dubnyk has got time as the Nashville Predators want to make a change. Long pass for Eberle. He gets bumped off the puck there by Jonathan Blum. Ellis plays it around the boards. Bistrick pinching in. Bistrick, good job to keep that puck in against Craig Smith and Nick Spaulding. Bistrick still has it, throws it towards the net. That goes wide, and it careened to Eberle, and he couldn't get a stick on it. Jones with it now. Ryan Jones from the corner. Jones turns, still has it. Shot deflected, and it took that stick right out of the hand of Nick Spaulding. So Spaulding without a stick. The Oilers in possession. Nugent Hopkins, though, gets pinned against the board. Jones in there to help him out. Back to Bistrick. Down low, and it got by Eberle. Now to the corner. Look at Nugent Hopkins get to it first. He is taken hard into the boards there by Jonathan Blum. Yip in there to try and get that puck loose. It's pinned against the boards. Everly's got it now. He's got Hall in front. Eberle going for the net. He'll get tripped up behind as he sends the puck out in front. Play continues. Good surge here by the Edmonton Oilers, able to get a change in with possession. Hall with the puck now. Taylor Hall still has it. Hall fires a shot, and that one deflected wide. Hall has it one more time. He'll play it back to the point. Ladislav Schmid gives it right back to number four. Worked over there by Brandon Yip. Behind the net for Horkov. Horkov, Hemsky, Hall, all kinds of pressure. Here's Hemsky with the puck now. Aleš Hemsky works it out in front. Aleš Hemsky to Horkov, feeds it towards the net. Puck is loose. Petrie down low. He'll get it to Hall. Taylor Hall with the puck. Gets double teamed. Sends it around the boards. Ladislav Schmid gets it to Hall. Horkov in front. Hall feeds it to the near side. Aleš Hemsky with it. Great pressure by the Oilers. Hemsky to Petrie. Petrie spins. Checked by Halaschuk. Delivers the puck to Hemsky. Hemsky, nice move around Ellis. Drop it for Horkov. Horkov back to the point. Petrie fires a shot, and that one blocked up high by Matt Halaschuk. He'll send it down the ice and head off.
Terrific shift there, Kevin, and some tough sledding for Edmonton. You got to battle through those checks. Nashville so good at kind of hitting and pinching you along the boards. You have to work through there. Good support. V's activating, getting down, and to keep that play alive a couple of times. And eventually it's the blast by Petrie that's blocked and down the ice, but over a minute and a half in the offensive zone.
Moving in now is Martin Irat. Irat checked by Bjarvi. Irat still has it back up top. Here is Klein with a shot. And Devan Dubnyk with bodies all over him in the form of Mike Fisher makes the save. Tell us, Oilers hockey from Rexall Place here on Sportsnet.
Well, Kevin, you talked about Pekka Rinne and the fact that he's either hot or cold this year for the Nashville Predators. 43 wins last year. Here's a quote that was from him not too long ago. Teams want to get a win against us, just take it to the shootout. I can't stop the puck in shootout. So obviously at times a fragile goaltender, but there's no question about it. When he's feeling it, he's feeling it. And he's one of the best in the National Hockey League. Pulled the last two starts that he's had. After giving up 6 goals on 16 shots, he's been a better goaltender in this game tonight versus Edmonton. He's made 20 saves so far.
Nashville Predators 2-5 in shootouts so far this season, so he may have a point.
Yeah.
But 76 wins over the last 2 years.
Unless it's reverse psychology.
Yeah, that's it.
Not sure yet.
Oilers have been to the shootout 4 times so far this season. Leonard Petrell with the puck now. Petrell, Brown, Smith up front, the fourth line. Will the Edmonton Oilers go to work? Brown behind the net for Smith. Got Petrell out in front. Hartley bounces it off the boards and away to the races. Klug moving in with Butler. Can't get him the puck. Good play by Whitney.
Great back check there by Petrell to get back and nullify the 2-on-1. Makes it a 2-on-2. Therefore, it can be more aggressively played. And it gets broken up.
Klug tries again. Gets a bump from Eberle this time. Ryan Jones at center. And offside is Jordan Eberle. Gino, what do you got?
Well, shop and swipe your club card at Safeway today. Watch future Sportsnet telecasts. You could win an all-inclusive trip for two to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, courtesy of redtag.ca. Shop and swipe your club card at Safeway today, and you could be our next lucky winner.
21-18, the shots on goal here. A lot more shots when these teams met March 8th. 34-24, the Nashville Predators outshot the Oilers. Smith,
boom.
Huge hit by Mark Fistrick right in front of the Oiler bench. Mark Fistrick came in with 52 hits. And he adds one right there.
Just a good clean step up right there. Perfect timing by Fistrick. And for Smith, you know, relatively new to the National Hockey League, doesn't know how good of a hitter Mark Fistrick is, and he just walked right into that one.
Eberle behind the net. Jordan Eberle lays it back to the point. It doesn't get there, though, and there is Smith. And he will chop that puck down the ice. The National Predators will get a change, and Smith's going to get the cobwebs out of his head.
Yeah, good to see him jump right back. I did a little look back to say, what was that? They just ran me over.
233 pounds.
Yeah, big man.
Horkov drops for Hall. Hall moving in. And that puck gets deflected off leg one, up into the seats, and it's a souvenir.
Well, here it is here. Missed the last eight games with an elbow injury. And Mark Fistrick, this is what he brings to the table. When you come across the line, you better be ready because he's there to meet you every time. And he does it so effectively. It's a smooth transition, pivots, gets another. Rob Blake used to hit guys like this all the time. But for Fistrick, he gets a little more body into it and just pops Smith in an area you don't like to be. For Craig Smith, gets up, shakes off the cobwebs, and he's right back at it, so good for him, but a real solid hit there.
Schmid shot doesn't get through. Weber plays it off the board. Schmid trying to keep it in and does. He'll get it to Horkov. Horkov to Hall. Hall centering pass, and it's stopped there by Fisher. Martin Erat with it now. Erat. And a good back check there by Hemsky. Gets the puck to Petrie. We're nearing the halfway point of this third period. A 1-1 game. All the scoring came in the second period. All the scoring on the power plays.
A little log jam there at the blue line and a good little chip up the boards by Edmonton.
Tonight's Netcams from Netcams brought to you by LASIK MD, providing you with a 2020 view of all the action. What we're seeing is a 1-1 game on the second game of a four-game homestand for the Edmonton Oilers, and 13 of their final 21, including this one, will be at Rexall. And Mike Fisher, another one of the guys that is hurting, and they can't afford to have him go down. It looks like his wrist
is cut.
Yep.
There's going to be a penalty here to Edmonton here for young Justin Schultz, who's had a little bit of a rougher night. Got a puck up in the face area, had to go get some repairs. And right here, tries to put it off the glass and gets a little too much puck, goes up right over top without touching, so therefore a delay of game penalty to him. So a tough break there for him, and Nashville goes in their third power play.
And that shot from Weber was a wrist shot that Devan Dubnyk made the glove save on. He'll hang on.
And you know, that's where Weber's really effective. He knows when to let that cannon go and when to kind of thread that wrister right through traffic. And right there, he was looking for a redirection, knew that there was a lane to get it through, but the traffic didn't get there in time, and Dubnyk's able to glove that one under the air.
Horkov is up front with Ryan Smith. This is Sergei Kostitsyn. Gets it to Leguan. Leguan back to Kostitsyn. To Leguan. Leguan moving in. Knocked down there by Bork to leg one, centered out in front, nobody home except Horkov, and he starts away with Smith shorthanded. Ryan Smith gets trapped by Weber. Kostitsyn has a lane as the Oilers make a change. Kostitsyn drops it to leg one, to the middle it goes to Bork. Bork to Weber. Weber fakes the shot, slap pass for Kostitsyn, didn't make it through. Kostitsyn gets it again. Sergei Kostitsyn. Being watched now by Sam Gagner. David Leguan takes a look, Weber's down low. Weber's got the puck now, but Petrie over there to get the stick in the way. Port centers it for Smith. Smith trying to jam it home. Can't do it. A minute and five of power play time remaining. Back to the point it comes. Sergei Kostitsyn dishes off to Weber. Weber fans on the wrist shot. Gets it back again. Kostitsyn down low. Bork's in front. Leg one. Gets it to Bork. Bork. Smith. Kostitsyn can't get that puck to settle down, and it goes out, and Gagne's on it. Sam Gagne moving in with Leonard Petrell. Gagne, shorthanded. Petrell fires the puck, he scores! Leonard Petrell, shorthanded goal! It's 2-1 Edmonton, and the celebration is on! The fourth shorthanded goal of the season for the Edmonton Oilers. They've got a 2-1 lead.
And a great job here by Gagne. First and foremost, Dale battles his old London Knight teammate Kostitsyn for this loose puck. Gets to it. It creates the 2-on-1. Petrell gets up there, makes himself available, and opens up. And he can really fire it right here. Good defensive play. To kind of get just a little bit of that puck to bobble it over Kostitsyn, and he finds his way to get through, takes a look back, knows that Petrell is coming, perfect pass, and for Petrell, he just teed that one up, and a little celebration afterwards too by the usually quiet Finn. He gives his team the 2-1 lead.
His second goal, he came in without a goal in his last 15 games, but he's got the goal shorthanded and has given his team back the lead. Roman Josi, still 15 seconds of power play time remaining for the Nashville Predators. Bouncing puck in front, cleared away by Smith. Josi steps into it. That was blocked by Horkov. Oh. Erad with it now. 4 seconds to go on the penalty to Justin Schultz. Erad with the puck. He'll play it back up top. Hammering that shot right on was Ellis. And out of the penalty box is Schultz. He'll give it to Smith. They want to make a change. They'll do that with 8:20 left to go. Here in the third period, the fans here at Rexall Place have come alive on this St. Patrick's Day. As Sam Gagner continues to rack up the points, he's got a four-game point streak now. Give him 27 points on the year. And the Oilers with 4 shorthanded goals. Devin Dubnyk's going to stop it in behind the net. He's got Hallischuk bearing down on him. Ryan Whitney with it now. Whitney takes a look. He'll give it to Justin Schultz. Schultz for Eberle. Eberle chops it in. Jones going after it against Klein. Spalling. Nugent Hopkins watching him as he gets the puck to Hallischuk. Too far. Petrie to Schmid. Schmid back to Petrie. Petrie with some room. Petrie glides across the blue line. Throws it towards the net. That one missed. Smith. Checked there by Petrell. Bork. Quick pass to Bartley. Bartley takes the bump from Petrie as he delivers the puck deep. Dubnyk trying to send it around the board. Schmid will try, but it is Legwine who comes up with it. Plays it right out in front. Dangerous chance for Bork. Legwine with it now. And in front for Klein. Another chance. Smith put it over top of the net. Push back here for the Nashville Predators with under 7 minutes to go in regulation time. Bork with the puck. Legwine with a chance. He is denied. Ellis pinching in. Now an opportunity to get it out. The Oilers will take that opportunity, and that's Magnus Bjarvi. Bjarvi gets the puck deep, gets a change in. Fresh bodies out there. It's Hall with Hemsky and Horkov.
Relentless work in that last shift with that line for Nashville. The best one for them tonight, especially Legwon and Bork. They've been very aggressive on the forecheck. Excellent at working it down low. Smith is injected in there, too, to add a little bit of speed. And it's been a nice trio for them in this game here. They've created a lot of chances down low in the offensive zone.
Kostitsyn, Erat, and Fisher, the forward line now. Weber with Josi. Erat turned away by Hall, gives it to Weber. Shea Weber across the blue line, dishes off Kostitsyn, gives it back to Weber. A weak shot directed and sticked away by Devin Dubnyk. Fisher on the far side, he'll play it back to Roman Josi. Josi can't keep it in, the Oilers able to chop it out. Here's Eberle with Hall, drop pass for Hall. Taylor Hall moving in, wrist shot, and he missed the target. Nugent Hopkins able to keep it in. Pekarinen will play it himself. A bouncing puck, and Nugent Hopkins desperate to try and keep it in. Did Weber. Now to Erat. Erat goes cross ice, gave it away. Ryan Smith out in front. What a save as Jordan Eberle was denied.
Good reaction there by Rene to get out and get that big paddle out there, poke check, and deny Eberle to have any time to make a play with that puck.
Well, congratulations to Christina Ruiz Serrano of Edmonton, who swiped a free club card, and on behalf of Safeway and Yoplait Yogurt, Minigo, or Tubes, has won a DVD prize pack.
Jordan Eberle with an assist tonight. He is still looking for his first goal in his last 11 games. Nashville Predators have taken a timeout with 5:31 to go here in the third period.
We're going to take another look at the goal by Leonard Petrell to give the Oilers a 2-1 lead here in this third period. Great heads-up play by Gagne. Just buys his time, waits for Petrell to get into position. He makes good on that one-timer as he drills it home.
his second goal of the season. An effective penalty killer. You're seeing him start to jump up in the rush. Now there's that celebration. See the tongue out a little bit. A little Michael Jordan-esque right there with the tongue coming out.
Funny talking to him. You and I were mentioning he was Skyping with his daughter.
Yeah.
And, you know, oh, yeah, look, yeah, this is what I drew for daddy. Okay, great. And then he calls on the cell phone, and his wife said his daughter is still holding things up to the cell phone saying, daddy, can you see what I drew? Daddy, and he's like, uh-huh, yeah, okay, sure.
That's tough. Long-distance relationship, obviously, with a young family, and he's been a real trooper this year, and I'll tell you, he's worked very hard. And it's nice to see him get on the board. Big goal for his team.
Yeah, against a fellow Finn.
Yeah.
5:24 left to go in regulation time. Magnus Bjarby. Some good speed. He gets stopped, but carrying on is Justin Schultz. He'll dump it in, going to chase it himself against Bartley. Takes Bartley into the boards. Magnus Bjarby trying to support that puck. Halischuk stopped up there by Gagne. Gagne knocks him down. Bartley and Klein on the blue line for the Predators. Long pass intended for Spaulding off his stick. Schmid will get there first. Lay it around the boards, waiting for it. Taylor Hall. Hall moves it to the middle, picked off there by Bort. But Halischuk was caught deep. Hall's got it again. Now winding up, Aleš Hemský. Hemský across the blue line. Hall heading for the net. Pekarinne steers that aside. Horkov chopping at it, trying to keep it in. Does temporarily. Now Ellis will get it and get it out to center. Shot right back in by Jeff Petrie. 4.5 minutes to go in regulation time. The Oilers looking for their fifth win at home this season. Petrie turns. Blum picks it up. Jonathan Blum across the line. He gets stopped. Hall and Eberle come together now. Eberle moving in. Jordan Eberle snaps a shot in. This time he scores. Jordan Eberle gets his first goal in his last 11 games. And insurance marker makes it 3-1.
And nice to see that wrister back, I'm sure, for all Oilers fans. Jordan Eberle, 34 goals last year. He's had a little bit of trouble putting the puck in the back of the net. Only 3 goals in his last 22 games played. But he's been starting to dial it in here. Nice little play here by Hall. Gives it to Eberle, drives to the middle, and he just zings this one home. So accurate, the shot looks up. He's got a little bit too much time to pick that spot. Puts it under the bar for a 3-1 lead.
Eberle with 7 goals and 19 points, 20 points now as he got a goal and an assist in this game. And the Oilers now looking to close out this game. Fisher right up the middle. Here comes Mike Fisher with a backhand and a penalty coming. And it's going to be a hook and call with 3:45 to go. And Nick Schultz is going to the box. And the penalty killers will go to work when we come back right after this.
Linda Olson, congratulations to you of Owhattan, who entered Score and Win and has won a Men's Bulova Chronograph watch, courtesy of Safeway, and you'll play yogurt, Minigo, or tubes.
On the 7th goal of the season for that guy, Jordan Eberle, Nick Schultz is in the penalty box for hooking. It is the 4th power play of the game for the Nashville Predators, and it comes with 3:45 to go in regulation time. Sean Horkoff against David Legwan. Predators control, Roman Josi being watched by Ryan Smith. Out in front, and it was a pass intended for Craig Smith. He drove the net. The net comes off the moorings. We get a whistle. Nashville with 3 power plays so far have generated just 3 shots. They are ranked 25th in the league on the road. And Barry Trotz has seen his team now in danger of losing their 3rd straight game and being swept through Western Canada. Bork will give it to Legwan. Schmid intercepts that, gives it to Petrie. Petrie sends it down the ice. Horkoff and Smith stay up front. Schmid and Petrie remain on the blue line. 30 seconds into this power play. Takes a funny hop. Craig Smith sees it go by him. Weber tees it up and went off the stick of Ryan Smith. And you know what that did to Smith's stick. That stick had no chance.
Obliterated it.
Petrell and Gagne out there now. Remember, they connected for a shorthanded goal at 10:53. Mike Fisher dishes to Weber. Weber centering for Fisher, snaps that shot, and he snapped it way wide. So wide that Roman Josi is going to have to go all the way back into his own zone. Erak across the blue line, fires a shot, and that was blocked by Ryan Whitney. 47 seconds left to go in the power play. Weber at the point. Josi, net empty. Six attackers on four. Petrell with an opportunity, shorthanded, backhand, and that one goes wide. That would be cause for celebration. We'd hear him cheering all the way back to Finland.
One of the good things about killing a penalty, if there's anything about it, with an open net, you can just rip it down the ice, not worry about the icing call, and go for it every time.
Over 2 minutes to go in this third period. 15 seconds left of power play time. Ellis fires a shot. He did not get all of it. Cleared away neatly there by Schmid, but it comes to Blum. Jonathan Blum goes behind the net. Centering pass. Spalling, Fisher, everybody. Butler banging away. Spalling chance. Still alive. Penalty is over. Still 6-on-5 now. Great effort by the Oilers as they collapse to the house.
Couple terrific saves by Devin Dubnyk. They were all over. And that's like what you see at the end of the warm-up when everybody converges on the goaltender and whacks away. And he denied every shot that was there.
Yep, gains the zone. Six attackers, net empty. Fires a shot. Blocker save. Gagne with it now. Gagne checked by Bork. Yep, runs right into Sam Gagne. Legwand comes all the way out in front. David Legwand takes a look, fires it towards the net through traffic. There is Devin Dubnyk with Bork right there. Let's take a look at the outstanding play, outstanding result. Brought to you by RE/MAX, Canada's most productive agents.
Well, it was a tight game, 1-1. Into the third period, it was a shorthanded goal by Leonard Petrell. Nice pass by Gagne. Petrell buries it in the one-timer celebration afterwards. A big goal for him, his second of the year.
And Jordan Eberle at 15:48 has given the Oilers some breathing room. And when it comes to closing out the game, Louis, that was your four key to the game for the Edmonton Oilers.
Let's be honest, it was your key.
It was your cue, we went with it, and you're right on the money, big guy.
I rarely get a chance.
Yeah, you're right on the money. Hey,
the blinds,
you're picking him for the rest of the year.
Blind squirrel finds a nut every once in a while. Less than a minute to go. The Oilers trying to even this season series against the Nashville Predators. Each team has one at home. Fisher fires it around the boards.
Whoa.
Weird hop off the stanchion. Paul comes up with it in the corner. Korkov with it now. Now it's Justin Schultz. Paul all over it. Josi denies him. 27 seconds to go. Alishemsky turns. Butler checks him, and then Spalling runs into 83. They push and shove. The puck's still alive as it comes around the near side for Taylor Hall. Bumped into by Bork. Weber in there as well. Butler with it now. Butler out in front. He comes for his balling. Quick shot. They score. Roman Josi fires it home, and it's a 3-2 game. 8.4 seconds to go.
Well, you know, we saw this from the National Predators back on March 8th when they won the game 6-0 over Edmonton. They were relentless for 60 minutes. They did not quit, and down by two goals here. There's only 8 seconds left in the clock when Josi pinches down, who's had a real good game for Nashville tonight. And a couple chances for Edmonton to get this puck out of the zone. They don't. And that relentless forecheck by Nashville pays off with a perfect pass through the traffic to Josi. And he jams her home with 8.4 seconds left, now 3-2.
Butler and Fisher get the helpers on Roman Josi's fourth of the season. And the horn sounds right away to stop proceeding, so we'll see if some time goes back on the clock. .8.4 showing right now. Pekka-Rinne remains on the bench. Brian Smith, Sam Gagne, Leonard Petrell, Nick Schultz, and Jeff Petrie on the ice right now. 9.2 seconds on the clock. Conversation about how much time should be up there.
Get as much as they can get. They've already got almost a second put back on the clock. The Predators have after that goal. We thought it was 8.6. Now it's 9.2.
From the faceoff, big scramble at center ice. The puck comes free. An opportunity now for Schultz with the empty net. He hit the post. Nick Schultz looking for his first goal, but it doesn't matter. The Edmonton Oilers defeat the Nashville Predators by the score of 3-2. And Devan Dubnyk gets his eighth win of the season.
And a real nice finish here for Edmonton. Looked like the Predators were kind of picking away here in the third period. This game was up for grabs. Nice to see Edmonton take control. Dubnyk closed the door. Two goals in that third period by Edmonton, gave him that 3-1 lead. Nashville almost cut the lead, but only to 3-2 as Dubnyk closed the door and they finish it off. That's closing out a game right there.
Nashville and Edmonton both now with 28 points. Final here, 3-2 for the Oilers. The season series tied at 1.
TELUS Oilers Hockey on Sportsnet. Brought to you by TELUS, the future is friendly. By Molson Canadian, brewed with the best this land has to offer. By Ford, go further. And by Rexall, feel good.